That enemy looking at you and he know he's thinking. Oh, I feel God. The children of Ammon sent and hired the Syrians and Beth Rebab and the Syrians of Zobah, 20,000 footmen, and of King Makkah, 1,000 men, and of Ishtab, 12,000 men. Ladies, I'm going to get to you real quick and let you go. And when David heard of it, now what the enemy does when he know you can be chumped by one comment, brother. Ladies, I love you, and this ain't supposed to be tit for tat. So if you're feeling guilty here, Pastor love you, he ain't trying to beat on you. But you tell your sisters, you know, your girls. Because the enemy found out that he could get one stank on them, look what he done. He go call for reinforcements up to 20,000, because he going to have everybody you ever kissed, you dated. Women just got a way of meeting other women that know somebody, that knew you back in the day and when you was in high school and you was a jock, and they just got somebody that knew somebody, and 20,000, before you know it, man, you got 20,000 reasons why. She won't leave you, but she got 20,000 reasons why she gonna keep you on lockdown, and you better not leave this house, and you better hurry up and get back home. Come on, somebody. It's in the Word. Ladies, I love you. Y'all just sitting there. Some of y'all must be guilty. Y'all ain't rejoicing. Y'all tell it. That's when it gets wrong. That's when you worship. That's when you, because then you put it on Beulah. That's when you worship. When y'all get quiet like that, I know y'all done some of it. Y'all tell it on yourself. That's why we fight so hard not to let to fail you at any time. And we having fun with this, but it's the truth. Because brothers, the message to you, and I'm gonna let you finish it, because I gotta hurry up and get out of here. And I gotta say something to the women, that God ain't forgot about you. He the only one that can clean up your past, have all them ex-baby mamas and all that drama and all the stuff that, you know, bad bills still chasing you. And stuff you thought you had gotten taken care of, and stuff people lying on you when ain't no reason. You know what I mean? Come on. You know, that's why you don't let the first wife and second wife and the third wife all go on a retreat together and you ain't there. You know, when one of them come back, you know, your first wife, boy, she just told me some stuff about you. You know, when you find that going on, that's when you fly your wife to Vegas somewhere. You say, baby, I've been planning this trip. Let's go. Come on, give me some love. You don't let ex-girlfriends. I'm just telling you the truth. Somebody ought to help me here. Brothers, am I right? You don't let the two of them be sitting together, riding together. And if you hear one day working on the same job, you be like, you know what? That job ain't for you, honey. Because them women will beat their gums. Ain't I telling the truth? And ain't that you got something to hide? You ain't just trying to hear that. Am I right? You ain't trying to hear that. Yeah, you're going to be helpful here in about 30 seconds. But you ain't trying to hear that. Tell me, I come in the door. Yeah, wife number two called me too, because me and her, I like her. You know, I really like her. Well, I don't care you like her, because I'm about not to like all three of you. Yeah, that's a brother thing. We'll discuss that in the convention. Yeah, you had three, you can't have four. Well, I had three, I can have four. Have five if I want to. Come on, grab your hand, brother. Oh, some of the sisters don't like that. Oh, they get mad at me. Look at me. They got quiet. Okay, honey, I'm sorry. All the married women looking at me like said they wish their husband wasn't at church today. They don't want him getting no ideas. And some of them, I wish he would go on. in TV land. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Ain't nothing sinful about laughing. Laughing is medicine. Y'all better come on. But that's what happened. Verse 7, and when David heard of it, he sent Joab and all the host of mighty men. Man, I'm going to leave that alone. Brothers, you need to read your Bible. When Jesus heard about it, that man, one little insult, and now the whole world came in, he hollered at Job, Brother Terrence, come on, Pastor. He said, Joab, get all the mighty men, roll down there. Roll down there to Lord's house, man. Straighten some stuff out. Roll over to Conrad's, man. I know he didn't roll over to my crib. Come on. Hey, brothers, don't be afraid. Say amen. When it's stacked against you, don't attack nobody. But know the Lord see. Just stand. The world would say it another way. This something. I'm just being honest with you. And that's how a lot of brothers feel. And they walk, Pastor. Why is he leaving? We was in church. We was going to. We was going. That 20,000 came at him. He was dealing with your mouth.
When you going to get a job? When you going to get a job? $12 an hour. We can't work on $12 an hour. $12 an hour. How we going to, how I'm going to afford that mean store? How I'm going to afford that, them trips? Who going to do this for me? Who going to do that? I was hoping to do it this year, that year.
No, he got that on him. Not that all that's not necessary. And he hearing all that. And then here come 12,000. Your mama and them, all them sitting up there. Your auntie, all them sitting there looking at him like, you know, you just really ain't that good of a man. Come on, somebody. X-Man come to tell, oh, it's class reunion. Oh, yeah. You hear my girlfriend. Oh, yeah. He got a business over there in Kansas. And girl, he just killing it. Ooh. Don't say that to you. Better talk to anybody. My wife don't do this, but you better not get to do it. I'm just playing. But that's what they do. Oh, girl, he got a rock and roll, girl. Yeah. Ain't said nothing to you. That's 20,000. And some of them, because they don't know they got reinforcement. That's me and you, brothers. Call me Joab. You can be Joab today. I don't care. Hello. Because when we was in the world, we go get us a six pack. Come on. Let's pop them the tops in the back of the truck, man. What's going on, man? Man, she's talking all that noise, man. Don't know how to leave this house, man. Leave up them kids. I'm out this bitch, man. Am I lying? Hello, brothers. Go stand around, tail. We had our tailgate parties for any football game today. Man, what's up, man? Man, you know what? I work like a dog, bring money in there. Man, she taking her butt, spending money all over the world. Man, this God Almighty, man. You know what? I'm about out this place. The brothers be, yeah. That's the 20,000. That's the wrong 20,000. But see, Jesus is raising up Joab and his crowd. Come on, brothers. When you talk to us, you say, well, come on, man, let's pray. Don't we? Come on, Andre, lead us in a song. Oh, the glory. Joy of the Lord is my strength. Look at somebody say, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Somebody say, what are you on? I'm on joy. I'm trying to tell you, y'all talking about we want to fill the church with men this year. Men love this kind of message because it's like Joab and his mighty men rolling down because they can't say some stuff at the house and they love it. They don't want to rumble it, tear up nothing, have to, I'm beat the chest like a gorilla, man. Listen to me. But men love this. You know why? It restores their glory. And men that don't want to hang around women all day. Five women, they want to stand in the middle of it and chit and chat. The Bible calls that effeminate. And the Bible says effeminate men gonna go to hell. You ain't got to limp your wrist to be effeminate. I get along better with women than I do with men. But why? I ain't mocking no homosexuals, amen, but you can come out of that. That's worship. My God, my time's up. Well, ladies, I guess I can't give you yours. You're going to have to find it on your own. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 11. Y'all need the brothers read the rest of the story. Verse 12, be of good courage and let us play the men for our people and for the cities of our God and the Lord. Do that which seemeth him good. And Joab drew nigh and the people that were with him unto the battle against the Syrians. My God, that's why God wants men to pray. God wants men to praise. Come on. I ain't going to let no woman beat me praising the Lord. It ain't sissified. Come on. It ain't that religion, because men are supposed to lead. I'd rather be soft before God, who's a man of war, than have to be soft before a woman. You're going to have to be soft before a woman. Don't get me wrong. It's okay to be soft for a woman in the right place, but I'm a warrior. Got any warrior men in this house? And that's what your sons and your uncles are missing. That feeling. Oh, man, y'all don't want me to talk to you. Because we've been made to feel that we're only men because we got something in our pants this long and we know how to use it. Somebody know what I'm talking about. This whole world is about, and yeah, and she'll be satisfied. She'll be satisfied. Oh, big old black dude and white dude. Yeah, and she gonna love it too. I'm saying, Igro, please. All you want to do is make us a bunch of circus monkeys. I ain't talking about your woman, but this world. If we can't jump out the stadium and we can't run through a wall, this world don't need us. But what about those of us that think with our head? And we are spiritual. All of us ain't track stars. All of us ain't football players. 9 foot tall with big old long feet. Some of us are 4 foot, 5 foot, and 6 foot, but we intelligent. And we loyal. But this world only celebrates those who are like test tube specimens. Big old chocolate day. Oh, Lord. Come on, brothers, let's worship. Forget these people who don't want to worship with us. That's why if you were sit with us and let us tell you when we was bad on the football field and basketball field, my God, we'll feel like, oh, shoot, now. That's what got you. Girl, I was getting, you know, big old belly now. Girl, I used to run. I put them down. We can't walk now, but I'll put them down. What you do, we get to talking, you get up like, I don't want to hear no more stories. He's like, damn, we ain't nobody listen to us. And so you wonder why we watch the television. Like we trying to reinvent or set a record. Man, I'm trying to cut this off. I wish he'd get out in front of that television, because there's something inside of us. We want celebration first, like you want roses first on Valentine's Day. Oh, that's helping somebody. We want you to do what Eddie Murphy mama done. Hercules, 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 Hercules. Your son wants it. Your grandson wants it. Am I lying, brothers? Brothers say, Pastor, you preaching today? Say it. Say, I'm getting set free. And I'm going to set my friends free. Yeah. Clap your hands. Okay, I'm going to give the ladies 2 minutes and let them go. They don't need much. Our ladies got it together. Clap your hands for them. They got it together. Ain't no fault in them. Clap your hands, brothers. Say, my girl ain't got no fault in her. My girl has no fault in her. You can preach it 2 minutes, Pastor, but my woman, She ain't got no fun. Hey, we ain't going to find none either because the games come on today. We got to get out of here. So, okay, I'm just playing. But I'm just playing. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 11. All right. And 15. Look at what it say right here. It says, and it's real simple. It's real simple. But ladies, look, young ladies, look, pay attention, please. This is for you. Because if you get this, you'll be good. No matter what age you are. I mean, I want you to meditate on it. Take it this week and chew on it. Because I won't be able to teach it like I want to and wear you out. But it says right there, but if a woman has long hair, it is a glory to her. For her hair is given for her covering. Now, I'm going to say something about hair. In this time and place, I can say, and I really believe, that we can metaphorically, if you know what that means, it means that a woman don't have to, have long physical hair. Somebody said, but it said right there. You changed it. No. I believe it's a sin, what it's saying, if a woman has long hair, and the long hair is just like Samson, his covenant was in his hair, but God ain't so fickle that hair is where the power is. Come on, let's think about that for a minute. You know the story about Samson in Judges chapter 16. You don't have to turn there because you know that story. We know that he couldn't have no strong drink, but we don't talk about the strong drink. We deal mostly about the hair. When the hair was cut off and Delilah finally milked that out of him, he lost his strength. Now, we're going to sit up and we're going to think God was like, is strength in your hair? But no strength in his hair. The strength was in the covenant that was made. And the covenant was simply this. God gave me the same covenant or a similar covenant. He told me some things that if I do this, or didn't do this, like a lot of other preachers were doing and people do. He said, the power I would give to you is unlimited. I told some preachers, man, and you know, they was quiet. They looked at me like, I wanted to say, well, you guilty? Because I'm not trying to judge you. But he told me some things not to do. And I'm not talking about with women. We all know that. But some other things. He said, he makes a covenant with you if you want power. If you don't want to be ordinary. He'll make a covenant with you. Because the Bible teaches that it may be, and I'm paraphrasing here, I should have the scripture, but there's some things that some people can do that you can't do. But it's not sin what they're doing, it's just you can't do it. Because I got a special covenant with you. And he gave an illustration of if somebody who was weak in the faith saw you eating or purchasing meat, the Bible says, from the shambles. And the shambles was a place where people, once they had killed their sacrifice, they would take some and offer their goat, their sheep, to false gods, idols. Because that's what you do with the meat. I'm going to offer this lamb to Molech and give it to him. Now, here come a new baby Christian or a young Christian or a Christian who was struggling themselves with not doing certain things. And they see Pastor Conley or brothers who so-and-so, and they see him over there at the shamble table buying some meat, getting this special kind of meat. They'll be like, dang, man, that meat sacrificed to idols. And you don't have to be a pastor. The brothers, they doing that. Ooh. Now, the meat was good. It's just the intent of it. So Samson's covenant was just God simply saying, if you would keep your hair, that's between you and me. You can braid it. You can jerry curl it. You can make it an afro. You can slick it to the side. You can put it in a ponytail. Do whatever you want to do. You can do it in any fad they doing in. Just don't cut it. Because we got a covenant. And I will continue to put power in your life because the very fact that all the other men is cutting their hair, everybody be wondering, well, this dude, who's this one dude with all this strength and what makes him different? Did you see the hair on that cat's head? That's Samson. God gets recognition from you in his covenant. You don't do certain things, go certain places, not because you can't, but it's because you and God got a covenant. If y'all saw me in certain places, y'all be, all of y'all be on the phone. Man, I seen Pastor, man, he was here and there. Because you would expect something. Well, people expect the same of you. But he's dealing with a woman now. And he's telling a woman that her glory is her hair. Because what she is saying, and we get all up in the links, what he's saying is that you should always have. Oh, boy, I'm getting trouble over this. Ooh-wee. Come on, I got to let you go. I'm getting enough to mess with you. For her hair is for her covering. Give me verse 16. Hurry up. This is for the ladies. But if a woman have long hair. Now, in this that I declare unto you, I praise you, not that you come together, not for the better, but for the worse. Okay, that's good enough. But the fact that what a woman does with her hair is shaved or short or long, she always honors her head. See, we think it's Islamic when we hear woman can't go out by herself. Because American women, we're so liberated. We get up 3 o'clock in the morning, man, in New York and places where they don't stop, and put on our high heels and red bottoms and step out and say, can no man tell me what to do? I'm free. But what he was trying to say, that if a woman would keep that mindset, whether she had a husband, not go out now, stay with me, or she didn't have a husband, but that she was always surrendering, she had someone, some covering, that she was surrendering to. She was holding on to her glory. When women get in trouble, when they get to say, can't no man tell me what to do. Baby, you's an accident about to happen. I don't want my daughter around you. I don't want my wife going around with you. Amen. I might can't stop her, but I don't want nobody with you. Ain't no man going to tell me what to do. Okay, baby, you stay away from me. You's a witch. Because you're going to put into her mind when I ask her sweetly, oh, my beloved and my betrothed, would thou please cook me a ham sandwich, please, darling, sure, baby, please. You're the reason she tell me get it myself. It's Tuesday, love. It's Tuesday. Thinkest thou that we can come for me tonight, darling? She's been hanging with you. Girl, I wouldn't do it until I get that Mercedes-Benz out of it. If you do that Mercedes-Benz, then the girl, but no, honey, no, baby, play him along. That's married or single. But when she starts to realize there's somebody, and this is where I'm going to hurt her. I'm going to kill him right now, Hammer. Please, Hammer, don't hurt him. There's some, I'm going to get in trouble. He may be my pastor. And pastors ain't got no right to sleep with you because they got authority. Oh, you wolves, that ain't what I'm telling you. It may be an uncle or an elder man. But somebody, a male. I sound sexist, don't I? Because, see, we're in 2022. And I'm bringing you the truth in this. But you're going to study her glory. If she's married, it's her husband. If she's not, it's the Lord. But the Lord has the fivefold ministry to protect you. Her glory becomes part of what ministry she's in, the house, because she's got apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, helpers, so she don't step into a trap with some ding-dong, whatever, because I'm free, baby. Ain't no man tell me what to do. And then you get one of them rascals. Want us to try to pray the devil out of you. But a lot of us, before we became men of God, we made some mistakes. But we've been transformed into the image of God now, and so the house of God becomes your cover. A lot of people don't like that. Jesus becomes your ish. The body helps be your mother to watch over you. You bring that book. Yeah, let him sit down and get uncomfortable with your daddy, which is the Lord, and with your watchman, and with your elder brother. Remember David's son, one of them killed the other because he molested his sister. There's some brothers in here, when they pick up that, you got your rascal over there, baby. Come here, let me holler at you about that nigga. Excuse me. We need to beat that. I'm sorry. Shouldn't have said that. But I mean that. Come here, let me holler at you, sister girl. We in the choir together. I see you praising the Lord, getting praised. But let me talk to you about it. Oh, I just love the ground he walking, girl. But let me tell you, he fooling. Oh, yeah. And you know what? Have you asked him? So the kingdom becomes your covering and your glory. Because the enemy wants to get you into something so you can stank, girl. Bless you, daughters. Come on, let's have a praise. I'm going to let y'all go because y'all all good. Point at some woman and say, boy, y'all good. Y'all like Mary. And Martha. Just like Mary. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Tell Martha not to moan. So these sisters in here ain't the only ones that can holler at you. Come on, Mondre know enough to holler at you, don't you? You got to trust him. Mario know enough, don't you? Wave your hand. Them your brothers. Y'all ain't believe this. Jesus said, who is, when they brought his mama to him, he said, hey, mama and your brother, them waiting out there for you. He said, who is my mama and my brother? But who did he did? When I came into the kingdom, I'm closer to some of y'all, more closer to my sister. I love her in the flesh, but I see her. I'm as close to her as y'all, some blood people.